So the red light means it's recording?
Yep.
Sweet. So we're like live on location for like the first time ever in a Brogetta movie.
We are in Kirth's house. Yep. Lots of stuff has gone down here.
Yeah.
Most famously, the Misfits fucking... And also the referees. I wish...
Yeah, we did the referees right in the other room.
This is the inaugural episode of the fucking Butt Sluts... Love Nuts podcast. that title's pending.
Patent pending, of course.
It's a patented title.
Oh yeah, so like I was just saying, before we start recording, because we missed a bunch of good stuff because we're stupid like that.
Yeah.
There's this new video, allegedly, of Kim Kardashian mowing down on some white dick.
She don't fuck white guys. I don't believe it.
I've seen some of the pictures. It looks like Kim mowing down some white pee-pee.
Hmm. Is it my pee-pee?
Short answer, definitely.
Short answer? Every answer about my dick's short.
This is the first time you're actually on camera instead of like just it going around,
yeah,
and like pointing at something.
They see me. They can see all of this.
See it for now, anyway. Until it goes away.
Yeah, until I just convert it to audio format.
Yeah, fans will never see that. Makes them all kind of depressed. How do you make a podcast anyway?
We're just gonna put it on YouTube. And people can listen to it there because we don't have a website.
So we're gonna have video still anyway.
Yeah, but it's just gonna be black.
Oh.
Listen to it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's kind of a cop out.
Yeah, we're really laying down our fan.
Yeah.
If we have any.
That is.
I don't know. TJ said he wants to watch.
Nice.
He just got a cameo. He got a shout out in the video.
TJ! She texted us like, K.
Yeah, it's more appropriate that way.
He's pretty angry about that shit, I hear.
See, and most people don't understand. TJ's the guy, if you say K or sure after he writes any text, it enrages them.
Yeah, not even just long text. Like, a lot of people are like, I just wrote you a book and you just said K. He could just be like, hi, and you're like, sure.
Yeah.
It ruins his fucking life.
I guess the good part about that is that's how I talk anyway when I text people, so I guess he just hates me in the end.
Yeah, how are you guys friends? He spots you, dog. That's probably pretty dangerous if he hates you.
Yeah, I've saved him enough times to where he won't, like, let me die.
He owes you.
Yeah, he kind of owes me. There's some fine ass bitches at the gym, though. I'll tell you that.
I hope so. Well, see, there's transitional bitches, too.
Yeah, there are a bunch of ones that aren't that great. But this is also a small town gym. Mm-hmm. It's not like if I was in Bloomington or Chicago or something. Probably a lot more hot chicks.
Oh, yeah, I assume. Especially Bloomington or anywhere where there's a fucking college nearby, because all the chicks are like, oh, God, I gotta look good for guys who wanna bang my vagina.
See, but then there's the girls who are like, I have a vagina. I don't have to do anything. Anybody will bang me anyway.
It's like, pro tip, if you're a girl, you're going to get banged by somebody eventually. Like,
yeah.
It's just the way it works. Fucking chicks rule the world on that aspect. So are we going to fucking create Killer Cadogan and shit today? Is that going down?
Yeah, first time ever Ren and Stimpy shall be on a wrestling video game in human form, no less.
We'll have to try to fuck with their, like, the way they look to make them look more cartoonish.
Sure.
You know, like...
Like, really ridiculously long ears for Ren.
Yeah, like, try to make them look, like, the proportions of them look all kind of fucked up, you know, like, make them, like...
Like, Ren's gonna be really, really skinny and
yeah. But he's also short.
Yeah. Stimpy is gonna be...
Fat dude.
He's gonna be fat and, like, almost like an oval. We can somehow pull that off. Honestly, I was thinking about it just now. He kind of looks like a stereotypical drawn sack of flour with legs and arms attached to him.
Yeah, I think that's how they designed him.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But I think it was more, they said it was a sack of kitty litter. And that's why they made him into a cat.
Oh, okay, that's fair.
Yeah.
What's Ren?
A mosquito.
Ren is originally a mosquito that's a chihuahua.
He's an asthma hound chihuahua. I remember that. I was like, asthma hound? That's a terrible name for a dog.
I fucking hate chihuahuas. Like, those dogs are ugly as fuck.
Yeah, I know, and they have huge heads, so they walk around, like
awkwardly.
They look like they're going to fall over all the time.
They do. Heads. When you're not looking, that's when they fall over.
Yeah. Girls have apple bottoms, chihuahuas have apple heads.
Check this out. So, girls like really ugly things and call them cute. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So, if a girl says a guy's cute, does that mean she's really calling you ugly?
Yeah, if she calls you cute, it's not good.
Oh, man, that sucks.
Yeah. Remember back in high school, my ugly car? Dude, your car's cute, bro. It was a station wagon, and it was silver, and it had a huge dent in the door.
Man. Bitches sugarcoat shit. And, like, they're harsh.
They are, dude.
Bitches like, so she's like, your car's cute, really, but in reality, what it really means is your car's fucking ugly, and I will never have sex with you in it.
Yep.
Other girls will, though. Cha-ching!
What can I say?
I still wish you had that station wagon. That was dope as hell.
I know, dude. It died, though. Like, and they burned it down. My dad was like, instead of, like, letting you try to fix it, what I'm gonna do is set it on fire.
Okay. It's like,
just one of the many responsible decisions that my dad's responsible for.
Yeah, there are numerous.
That's why he's an Alabama slammer right now.
I heard my mom actually said he's on the most wanted list or something.
Mm-hmm.
What the fuck does that mean? How can he be on the most wanted list if he's already in custody?
Because I think Alabama's a non-extradition state.
So he's wanted by Illinois?
Yeah, because he skipped out on his probation.
I thought he got like permission to go there first.
I thought he did too, but... what do you know? My dad lied.
Yeah. Well, then. Huh.
Constantly let down by my actual family. Bug him. Bug him. So I got a fucking text from Emily last night, dude.
Are we going to use real people's names in this podcast?
I don't give a shit, because I'm not saying anything bad.
Oh, okay.
But it was just, it's weird. Like, she's like, oh, fucking, I was in love with you. I think she was drunk.
New rule. If you break up with somebody.
Especially if you do it in a harsh fucking manner and then you immediately get with somebody else.
Yeah, that's really fucked up.
You're not allowed to say that you're still in love with them ever.
Yeah. New rule. You gotta delete the person's name so that way you can't drunk text them. Mm-hmm.
I deleted her from my phone.
You're like, that's who is this?
I was confused at first.
I still love you. Who are you?
Somebody still loves me?
No, I love you.
Heartbroken.
Yeah. For us that couldn't see it, he just made a heart gesture and broke it.
With my hand and broke it.
Yeah.
I keep doing it even though I know there's not going to be any video.
But it's even more awkward because he's not wearing pants and he's bending over showing me his butthole doing that.
Yeah.
So
doing it over, using my butthole as a backdrop to the broken heart. I have a
the heart has been pierced many times.
I have a blazing pink butthole.
At least you don't bleach it.
Yeah, I bleached the shit out of that shit.
Inside jokes.
Inside jokes for the win, you know?
Nobody knows what's going on.
Let's just call her Feather. Feather Black.
Sounds pretty accurate.
Yeah, it's a pretty good fucking name. You're good at coming up with fake fictional character names. I'm yeah. good at disguising people's real names.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna call her Cammy.
Jeff and Jabba.
Oh man, mine's the best.
Yeah, it's just my homie that I work with that I'm talking about banging in text yeah. message.
Yeah, what's up, yeah. Jeff? I'm gay.
So yeah, go back to that story of Emily. What?
It was just that weird. Was it? Like she's been texting me. Like, well, I guess her and her new boyfriend broke up. And
already?
Yeah.
And now she wants somebody
to fall back on, but it ain't happening. I'm moving forward and upward. Well, probably just forward.
Forward and upward.
I never go upward.
Yeah.
Trail. I kind of trailed down, but
you're going down. So you're saying...
But I'm going down swinging.
So you're saying, sugar, we're going down swinging?
You know it.
Going down, 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 down. Okay, anyway. No, so what you're saying is, from the first one?
No, I've been kind of doing this lately. Because Cindy, while cool...
Everybody's getting put on blast, every bitch. Yeah, it is what it is.
Okay, I'll put every bitch on blast.
They're on blast.
Everyone who fucking broke my heart, fuck them.
Alright, so... No, I meant from the first engagement. So you're saying, Cindy. Oh, you're engaged to Cindy?
Yeah. I forgot.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, that's how fucking unsubstantial it was.
Oh, okay. So.
Yeah. So, but then Cindy's prettier than Carrie for sure. Like it's not even.
Okay. No, yeah. Okay. No. So then you went back up to Trisha. Then down to Anita. Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying putting.
You're saying, huh?
I wasn't engaged to anything.
I know, but you're still, like, with her.
Yeah, I think her and Trish are, like,
okay, about. Okay, that's fine.
They kind of look alike.
Yeah, they kind of do.
Yeah, it was weird.
I mean, not like a super...
Just enough of a resemblance where you kind of, like...
It reminds you.
You're like, I notice a pattern.
Yeah, it's like, you also have a red streak in your hair. Mm-hmm. She wears a red streak in her hair wig. This is kind of...
Yeah, and she had one styled up like Sarah Palin, which was kind of weird.
That was cool, though. I like Sarah Palin. Yeah. But anyway.
And actually, I think I put Emmy on the same level as those guys, too. Emmy's really pretty, but I don't know. Different way.
I've been seeing her getting dropped off over at David's lately. Like, when I drive by and, like, come home from the gym or whatever. Mm-hmm. Sorry, like...
Well, that's kind
of... Wait, that was in the morning. That was the morning when I was going to the gym once, like, Saturday or Sunday.
Yeah, she pretty much stays over there.
And that was, like... Is that Emmy? That was like the day after you broke up, like literally the morning after you told me about that. And I was like, bitch!
You bitch!
What are you doing?
And you know what? Like, I'm not saying that I'm a perfect dude here, but every one of those breakups...
He really is saying he's a perfect dude.
Every one of those breakups was like not at all my fault. I guess it was my fault for ever trusting a bitch. True story, don't trust bitches.
Yeah, you heard it here from... The Skank Slayer, don't trust bitches, which sounds kind of awkward coming from him, but nonetheless.
Yeah. Especially because I always end up trusting bitches.
Yeah.
I don't practice what I preach, like, even a little bit.
Yeah.
But it's just weird to get texts from somebody like that, like, and she's like, I miss you so much, I wish you would still come around and hang out. Like I want to fucking hang out with you, really. Look
at my The camera can't help it.
It's drawn to the infinite blackness.
They came from the darkness.
So we got some fucking sweet football going on this week too, huh?
Yeah, did you catch any of the football games yesterday? Sports segment.
I did see Texas get beat, Ohio State get beat, and that's all I cared about. But
it was a great day for me. I enjoyed watching Texas lose, and I enjoyed Ohio State losing.
Yeah, fair enough. Hate is gonna hate. Hate is gonna hate.
Hate is gonna hate. This show will only have hate. There will be very rarely love shown.
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot of hate between the co-hosts, which is weird.
Yeah.
Because we hate everything that we each other likes.
Yeah, how does that make sense?
I don't know.
This show's doomed to fail. We're already fucked.
Well, our friendship has lasted this long. I think we could probably support a podcast.
I'm shaking my head now.
Yeah, I'm shaking it violently hard.
Actually, you're just choking me.
Fucking. Also, like, my reputation as a terrible skank slayer has already preceded me to Walmart. Everybody knows.
Well, because of that one girl.
Yeah, it's no.
Over there. She told the other girl.
Nah, she hasn't.
Then how would she? What did Kenny tell? Did Mr. Ken tell
those?
He
probably did. He was probably telling stories about me before.
Dude, this guy's coming.
Brogan's gonna work here, and what you don't know about Brogan?
Well, that one. One bitch was dating your cousin, right? That Walmart? Sarah?
I think so.
Yeah, Matt? Is your Matt your cousin?
Yeah.
I think, wasn't he? I thought he was dating her at one point.
Well, he's not my cousin, but like where, like he used to be through marriage.
Oh, so it's not blood.
Yeah, that's his baby mama.
Wait. What? No?
Matt Price?
No, not Matt Price. I meant Matthew Brogan.
Oh, no, that was Molly. But she didn't work there anymore.
I could have swore to God.
You might have too.
I could have swore. Maybe I'm completely wrong.
No, you might be right. I like it because that just seems like.
You just have to ask him now.
Yeah, I'll be like, hey, Matt, did you ever bang? What's her last name? I don't even know. It's just Sarah. She looks like she could almost be hot if she had good teeth and also if she didn't look like she was a chewed up taffy person. But she looks like she's incredibly stretched out.
Really?
Yeah, like I've noticed that.
Huh.
Because I was like. Hey, you got a nice butt, but the rest of you looks like it's stretched out.
Yeah, but you still bang her, right?
Yeah.
Even with her fucked up ground looking like a taffy person?
I just fucking buried in the pillow.
Yeah, I thought it too.
Brandon has no standards.
You and Jeremiah are pretty neck and neck.
Yeah, but I think Jeremiah likes chicks that are blatantly not hot. And I love him for it.
Yeah.
He's just like, fuck it, it's better than jerking off. And that attitude...
But you have to at least respect that.
Yeah, because...
At least he's honest.
Yeah, like, he's honest about it.
Now, this other guy, we'll call him Matt Norman.
That sounds like a totally fake name. Matt Norman, no one will ever suspect.
He went through this phase of where he tried to convince us of girls that he was fucking were not ugly and not fat, which... Yeah. they completely were, but he was, like, in denial. Like, at least now he accepts it, yeah, which is cool. It's like, dude, if you like the bitch, it doesn't matter what we think, but if you, like, try to pass it off on us like she's hot, and try to tell she's hot, we're gonna shut you down.
Yeah, we're gonna be like, no, because we're your friends and we're allowed to do that kind of shit. Yeah. You have to put up with it.
Yeah.
You chose us, man. It's like having a gay friend who's in the closet and you're like, just tell me you're gay, dude. Like,
don't we have one of those?
Probably a couple. We have suspect.
People are on suspect. Your character's suspect, dog.
Put him on gay blast.
Yeah, gay blast. That was a shitty siren. Supposed to be a police siren.
Pound the alarm!
That just looked like you were gonna punch somebody's asshole.
Maybe. A blazing pink asshole.
Oh! So, if you punch somebody in the asshole and pull it out real quick, would it make it like a... Like a...
Can you pull it out? Because your whole fist going into a butthole.
Your asshole can expand pretty far to fucking drop turds out that thing, though.
Like, yeah, but it's not size. Like instant. Like it's not like your size. Butthole goes, and they just drop out. And the turd comes through and forces it only
over. Wait, so would it not make a sound because it's coming out so fast? It, like, wouldn't even have enough time to make it, like, a tight seal and, like, slowly come out? Well, it's like, woof! Like a cannon like, shut out. Whoosh!
I think that's how it would go down.
Huh. By the way, if anybody actually ever does listen to this or watch this, please chime in with suggestions. Maybe one day we'll even have callers during the filming.
We could do that.
Or special guests.
If we get any more than one fan. But also, man, question of the day.
Question of the day? I was not prepared for this segment.
This is for the viewer. We need to know.
For a viewer.
Okay. If you're getting a blowjob and a chick blows into your dick, will you fart?
Play devil's advocate. What if she blows in your ass? Do you pop a boner?
I do.
Yeah, I got first-hand knowledge of that.
But like I said, if any chick ever wants to get that close to my butt, then she's risking her own face.
I'm completely interested in this. If any girls out there have blown in a chick's guy... blown in a guy's dick and had him fart, please fucking let us know. Yeah. I don't even care if it's fake. Just sound like you're just real.
Let us know from experience. Also, on a side note...
Yeah.
You know how like sometimes a girl's like, I'll let you put it in my butt if I get to put a finger in your butt. I always gotta tell them no. And not because I'm like, ew, that's gay or whatever. I just don't want to bang a chick with a melted off hand. Because that's what would happen if she put her finger in my butt.
Are you saying your like anus is like radioactive?
My anus is heinous.
Heinous.
It's fucking toxic back there. Like if you jumped in it, you'd get superpowers.
I am interested in getting superpowers though. So. How much percent chance you think if I did that I'll get superpowers?
100%.
That makes me wonder.
Do you consider cancer a superpower?
Can I give other people cancer while having cancer?
That would be a shitty superpower, but yes.
I would accept that superpower. Do I have to? What's the rules to that? Can like I just like point at somebody and be like, you have cancer, or do you like? Have to touch them or something, or how would that work?
I don't know. I guess you
for it to be fair, in this alternate reality where I could do that in the first place. I'm Cancer Man.
I don't know. I really don't know the rules on that. But I mean, while we're on the subject, worst superpower, we got to do
worst superpower. Ooh.
And you can't just be like Aquaman, because Aquaman has superpowers.
That's my first thought. It was Aquaman.
Yeah, like, he's the worst.
He sucks.
He's the worst superhero.
Okay.
But he has cool powers.
I saw this show last night. It was on, like, Disney or... No, it wasn't Disney.
It was the Wizards of Waverly Place, wasn't it? You're like, magic is the best power.
No.
Selena Gomez is the best power.
Selena Gomez has the best powers.
She has hot Latina powers.
Yeah, she has hot Latina powers. And she probably doesn't speak Spanish or anything, no. I'm guessing.
Probably not. She's a
southern California. She's one of those, like, yeah, she's one of those terrible Mexicans. Can't even, like, speak Spanish.
Yep. Take Spanish in night school and get a B.
Yeah. How did you fail? No, worst superpower. It was some show last night, and it was, like, really lame, and I probably shouldn't have been watching it because it was, like, stupid, and it was, like, for kids or whatever. But, like, I still watched it. And, the one guy's power was he could glow. He could legitimately just glow.
Just glow?
Yeah.
Okay, that is pretty bad.
Another guy could turn himself into, like, a pool of liquid. Just, well, just drop to the ground.
That could be useful, because you could drown the shit out of somebody in it.
Yeah, but how would you get out?
Or you could become a hot chick's bathwater.
Oh, yeah. But, like, his colors... whatever's touching him basically... like, his clothes even, like, dematerialize to water, too. So, like, if he touched you, could he, like, fucking turn you into water?
Apparently, unless his clothes are special.
I don't think they were. They just look like normal clothes. Hmm. So, like, could he, like, re...
Yeah, like, if he jumped on you and like, liquefied, could he fucking just
destroy it? Yeah, could he, like, just turn back into normal and you're just fucking dead puddle? Maybe. It sounds like a really cool superpower.
Yeah, see, that one's pretty cool. Like, if they... In the right hand.
Depending on the rules to that one.
It's like this, this is an X-Men character named Cypher. And his power is he can understand any language. And, like, that's really fucking lame. Like, really lame. But they made it cool because they're like, well, he can also understand body language. So now he's, like, a fucking really crazy martial arts guy. And he just really? Sees, yeah, like, whenever, like, and he knows exactly what the opponent's going to do because he can read their he can read their fucking body language. So I guess it's all in the interpretation.
Yeah, that's, glowing, that's pretty sweet.
Glowing.
Yeah, he's a nightlight.
I guess, like, if you fucking meet a really hot chick who's afraid of the dark... You're going to notice I take this a lot back to how this would get you laid. That's kind of my thing.
Okay, now this one is going to be really fucked up since you just mentioned that. This other chick's power, she can shape, she can morph. But she can only morph into a hamster.
Oh, yeah. That's going to be one melted hamster with superpowers. Oh, man. That would be shitty, too. Because, like, what practical application does a hamster have in battle?
What doesn't it?
Yeah, true. I mean, have you ever seen the movie The One? The beginning, that rat has fucking huge nuts, but they're actually explosives, and they fucking explode.
Wait. So he's like explosive rat nuts?
Yeah, explosive.
How does he walk? Nuts. He's a rat with like huge nuts. How can he walk? How can he walk?
He kind of waddles a little bit and drags the nuts on the ground.
It's like... Like, walk bow-legged?
Well, rats walk on all fours.
I know.
You think we're gonna think of
Splinter? No, I meant, like, his front legs would be normal, then, like, his other ones would be, like, out, like, way to the side, like he's bow-legged. Sky. Yeah, like Heels to the Sky camp. Still the greatest fucking pole vaulting camp ever.
Yeah, first of all, it's a pole vaulting camp, which is awesome. Second of all, Heels to the Sky. Come on.
And chicks, and hot chicks are wearing it.
Yeah, and they didn't get it. Yeah. Well, they probably got it.
Oh, they got it all right. Oh, yeah.
Not for us, though.
How do you know?
But Ken could have, remember. Oh, could have. Ken talks a lot of game. But yeah, he's really beast mode at work. He's not lying about that.
Okay.
I was really surprised.
I'm better.
I was thoroughly surprised.
I'm better.
Did you work housewares or hardwares?
I worked... fucking everywhere in that store, dude. Except the only place I really didn't do was toys and automotive, because
they do that on their own. But yeah. I mean, sometimes I have to stock it too, but that's only free time.
I didn't do electronics because the people like coded for that do that one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I don't know if it's still like that or not, but
yeah, it is. We have one guy who does electronics picks, and that's about it.
Okay. Yeah, otherwise I did like everywhere else.
Yeah, see, the only areas I've been at a lot are chemicals and hardware and luggage.
Our podcast sucks. We just started talking about Walmart.
Yeah, I know, but
that's working at Walmart.
We have a lot of experience there.
Yeah, I guess so. We have experience sucking.
Yeah, sucking at life. That's why we made this fucking.
We need to get some bitches on here to talk about sucking. They're pros.
Yeah.
Wait. Allegedly,
not
girls
in Pontiac. They're not.
Allegedly, girls in Pontiac do not give blowjobs. Please come in and disprove us.
Yes. Like, if you... Well, that one chick gives blowjobs, but...
Which one?
The one who sent me that message.
I don't remember this.
When I posted that video about that, and she was like, if you ever want me to suck your dick, I will, and then you can have a good story.
Do it!
No, she's Norman style.
I don't care now.
I care.
Somebody has to disprove it. She has to You have to, like, do it so that way we can know if she gets good blowjobs or not.
I have bad experience with the blowjobs. Most of my videos on my site are about bad blowjobs.
Lockjaw.
Lockjaw, fucking...
Claw?
The claw.
It's kind of like that one Derek comedy video where it's just like...
Yeah, I know,
like,
man.
Smashes it.
Like, that is, like, the absolute worst it could get, but somehow mine was worse. Because she started chewing on my dick.
She nibbled it?
She was like...
don't use your teeth! Who does that?
A little scrape is fine. No, it's not.
It's never fine.
It's not.
It's not.
If anyone tells you that, they're a fucking liar and they're not your friend.
Scrapes are fine.
Little scrapes.
This is a shout out to all the statutory wearing braces out there for keeping the metal. Woo!
You gotta shout out to statutory.
Someday they'll be in the major leagues. Just remember that.
Exactly.
Keep them on the back burner until then.
Yep. There's grass in the field, play ball. There's no grass, sometimes you gotta
flip the bitch over, go mudding.
Go mudding.
Wear your cowboy hat too, bro.
Get you some donut.
Get you some Hershey's donuts.
Oh shit, these donuts are about to get glazed. Speaking of fucking baked goods.
Yeah.
What about fucking sitting here with the goddamn baker himself.
Cream pie baker. That's me.
Don't come inside me. Okay. Fucking liar.
I believe in...
procreation? Sex for only procreation?
Yeah, I do. And, so... I will only shoot it up in there. I'm not fucking gonna shoot it outside.
No.
You just gotta be prepared for that if you're with me.
Yeah, I definitely got fixed just so that I could only exclusively do that forever. Yeah. Unless a chick's like, do it on my face! And I'm like, I'm doing it on your face.
I'd be like, alright. And just jam it in there. And that's not my face! I know.
I'm sorry, it looks like a bulldog's face. Oh!
Oh, shit! That's some bestiality, though.
It looks like a bulldog.
Bestiality.
A sandwich.
Arby's is her favorite restaurant.
What I'm trying to say is, your vagina is not attractive.
You don't give a fuck, though.
I do. I've actually never encountered
a roast beefy
vaginas, yeah.
How about some meaty lips?
Yes, but not bad looking. Kind of like burger-ish.
Oh, like the one hamburger video where the guy like grabs it and he's like, boop, boop, boop. And it's like,
hey.
Yeah, it really legitimately does kind of look like a hamburger.
It does a little bit.
But she was like still cool. Like, I don't mean cool like that way. I mean, it still looked good and I would still hit it.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Okay. By the way, randomly completely switching topics and gears 100%. That Sprite can came out the year Tim Duncan was a rookie. Damn. Never been opened.
Is it a commemorative one?
I don't know.
I
think it is.
Okay,
I was like, well, he's a Spur and I like the Spurs, so I just kept it from his rookie year, and now it's almost empty because like
evaporation.
Evaporation out. So.
Aww.
But it's still unopened, all that shit, like untouched really for the most part.
Huh, that's crazy.
Yeah, I know. I thought so too. Except when I get really thirsty.
Hey, you're like, oh, I wish that there was
some. I wish there was some spread in here.
Oh, the spread looks so fucking good. Listen, there's some fucking sweet fucking Stairway to Heaven in the background.
I know.
I feel like it gives our podcast gravitas. Uh-oh, Facebook
updates, everyone. Philly.
Shooting a podcast, Kirth!
Oh my god! This is like Led Zeppelin Day, apparently.
I know.
For the immigrant song, now?
It's about hobbits. What isn't, though?
You're about hobbits. Did you have sex with a hobbit?
I used to work with a chick named Rosanna, who was really short, and she said she had furry feet, and I would totally have given it to a raw dog. So.
What? I have never heard about this girl. Is it Rosanna, like the chick that Wax talks about in his song, Rosanna?
No.
Oh, okay.
But I love that song.
She said that she has furry feet.
Yeah. Not like furry, like, oh my god, it looks like I got fucking toupees on my fucking feet. She was like, yeah, I got like furry, like I got a lot of hair on my feet, and since I have really dark hair, it shows up. And I was like,
is she Indian?
Nah, she was like Italian or something. And I was like, I'm not really interested in your feet, bitch.
That sounds strange. She sounds like more like Latina than.
Yeah, no, she was like Italian, like dark haired Italian.
She's really short.
Yeah.
Like a midget almost.
Like
Lacey?
5 foot.
Kind of like Lacey?
Maybe. I think she was about Lacey's height actually, but she was like really stacked. Like she had huge boobs.
So she looked really out of proportion.
No. Looked really good. Like really good.
So maybe her boobs weren't really huge, but they just looked huge on her body frame.
Well, she said she had 36 D's.
That just sounds like...
Not double D's. Regular that sounds... D's. And that she sounds... never wore a bra, but her boobs didn't look saggy. They always looked really perky and held up. And she's like, I don't believe in wearing a bra. And I was like, that's crazy that your boobs are that good.
Really?
Yeah.
See, that sounds just like... not hot, like...
Dude, if you saw it's her, proportionate to me. But yeah. the only thing wrong with her, really, was she had mom face.
Mom face.
Yeah, she just looked like you looked at her face and you're kind of like, you look like a mom. Like, stereotypical in your...
How the fuck does that work?
I don't know.
But I've never heard of you, like, ever say that or anyone ever.
That's why I never brought this chick up before.
Because she had mom face?
She had mom face. Like, she didn't look like my mom or your mom.
Can you name...
a mom. Can you...
Wait, all girls with kids have mom faces. Think about that for a second.
Yeah, I know, but some girls who have kids don't look like they need to be moms. Like, Anita has a kid. She looked like a mom.
Yeah. She can have two.
Yeah. She pregos. She's preggers.
She's already... Didn't she already break up with that dude?
No, they're back together. It was Cold Feet.
Ultimate Warrior?
Yes! Can't see it right now, but we're shaking the shit out of these ropes. Yeah, I never mentioned that chick because she had mom face, but she was pretty
Can
hot.
You name one other person, like maybe celebrity or something, that has a mom face?
No.
So it's not. So it's not, she's the only person. Phenomenon. She's the only person ever, apparently, with a mom face.
She apparently is. I guess I don't know. Fuck you.
You couldn't bang her because she had mom face.
I didn't say I wouldn't bang her. I said the only thing wrong with her.
So that's not. It must not be enough wrong. They can still bang her.
No. Is there anything enough wrong with a chick where I won't bang her? Really?
I don't know.
It's never
a good question.
I've never encountered it.
Well, she has no teeth.
I'm banging Trisha Jones.
She has no teeth?
Well, she has false teeth on top. From meth.
I would never bang with dirty bitches.
I know. That's why you're better than me, Keith. But it's okay. We accepted it.
We've accepted this a long time ago, ladies and gentlemen.
Our friendship works like this. Keith's better than Brandon. Keith puts up with it. The end.
The end. All right, cut scene. Movie over. Roll the credits. Yeah. That sounds like a phenomenon, like mom face.
I know. I want to. I'm gonna type it into a search bar.
Do it right now.
I'm going to. I'm going to look on a fucking website that we can't say because of copyright reasons. And mom face.
YouTube?
I think we're okay because we're going to post this on YouTube. Actually, Google owns YouTube, so we're okay. I'm Googling mom face. How to Google mom face.
I'm Googling your mom face, dog.
Oh, just got a text.
From Emmy.
No. She's at work.
Where's she work at?
Wendy's.
I don't even know that.
Yeah.
Is it a girl?
Yeah, it's my roommate's daughter. She wanted to know if she could use my laptop.
No.
Like, there's so much porn on there. Why would you even? I left my porn up one day.
There's nothing wrong. It's yours.
I know. But I mean, like I was kind of embarrassed because she used my laptop and like it was still up after she used it. So I was like,
just put it back to how it was before she, like.
Yeah, I know. She was like really respectful about it. It's just funny. Okay.
Guys, look at porn.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, okay. I didn't know if you knew that or not.
I blatantly know that.
Oh.
I've been in a couple, so.
Yeah, son. Wasn't it the same person?
No.
Every time?
Mm-mm. One time it was Cindy and Anita at the same time.
One time it was just Anita.
One time it was just Anita. One time it was just Cindy. And one time it was Trish Johns. And one time it was Megan.
Jesus.
And that one time it was Georgia.
Goddamn.
Yeah.
George's real name's Amanda, by the way.
Yeah. I should probably say that because I actually know somebody whose name is Georgia now, and I don't want anyone to assume that I've
been married
to
you. Why, she not hot?
No, just, she's married. I don't want to fucking fuck up her life.
You fuck up lives. This thing fucks up lives!
Okay, this chick has a mom face, but her face isn't like that. Like...
That's a mom face?
Yeah, she looks like a mom.
Who's this?
I don't know. I just typed in mom face, and it's one of the results.
I bet. I would slam it when she was younger. Not so much now.
No, you would now, too.
Okay.
You want to go door to door and bang MILFs.
I know.
Like, that's your life's ambition.
I want to... Let me see this one so I can jerk off for a little bit. These are mom faces?
That's what it says.
Mom face.
I mean, that's all I search for.
Look at this bitch. This bitch looks like Miley Cyrus. She looks angry as piss. She looks like...
She looks angry as pissed?
Dude, she looks like... For some reason, I know she doesn't look like this guy, but this is what she reminds him. She looks like Zach Braff with Miley Cyrus's haircut staring at you like he's about to yell at Turk. Now, tell me that's not true. Can you see that?
Yeah, I can see that. That's very specific, but I can definitely see that.
Wow, that is pretty crazy.
For once we agree that something looks like something.
That, like, never happens.
Yeah, like, one time I literally sent him a picture of my brother and was like, hey, man, doesn't this guy look like Brian? And he was like, no.
It didn't look like him at all, dude. Not even a little bit.
It was him.
It didn't look like him. Oh, man.
I don't know what this picture is. Well, oh, that's two different pictures. I thought it was a picture of a hot chick. And then, like, a picture of what looks like Doug Funny's teacher. Like, split screen. Like,
Doug
they're saying
Funny's
this
teacher.
Is who she looks like.
I've seen that before. Like, it feels like I've seen that, but I don't know who the hell that is.
I don't either.
I'm not making the connection with Doug Funny, though.
I'm gonna look dad face now.
Dad face?
Dad face.
The fuck is dad face?
Apparently.
Apparently
this is dad face.
That looks like a Chinese guy. They get, like, uppercutted.
Yeah.
It's like slow motion.
The chin.
They, like, yeah.
It's impossible!
It looks like the impossible guy, and he, like, they just, like, fucking took the picture right at the right opportunity. Right time period and everything.
For him to
like,
have his
it.
Fucking chin up by his ears.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think it could have been any more, like, well shot than that.
I like it.
Impossible.
I have a child. I'm a dad. I don't have a face like that. Maybe you should uppercut me.
Well, you don't have round eyes, so.
I know. Well, I've looked at Chinese eyes, so.
I know. Asian bitch.
Fuck you, round eye.
Fuck you, round eyes.
You'll never win the kumite.
You're
not Tanaka.
I'm not Tanaka. That's actually true.
I'm not at all Tanaka. That's crazy.
True fact, I am not a Tanaka.
If you were Tanaka, then you could show me Demak.
I'm gonna Tanaka those boots tonight.
Oh yeah!
Regular show.
Yeah.
Oh
yeah!
Oh man.
So have you decided what you want to eat yet, besides my asshole?
You got a spoon?
Yes.
I'm saying... Motionless and White, I like their two singles.
I don't know, man. I downloaded their first album. I haven't heard the rest of their second one, but I'll probably download it now since
good
I really like the America song. I liked it. It's different. It's like the singles are different than most of the songs on there, but he does more singing in the other songs.
Good or bad? Why does he look like the guy from AFI?
He does, like, a lot. And he has a stupid name, too. The guy from AFI is, what, Danny Havoc or whatever?
Something like that.
And I think his name is...
He's a big faggot.
His name is, like, Danny Motionless.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Maybe he is Danny Havoc.
I don't know, dude. This guy's pretty metal, comparatively, voice-wise.
Have you listened to that song, 17 Crimes, yet, that I keep trying to, like, make you listen to?
Nope.
Dude, it's good.
Because you haven't linked it to me. But I didn't
bullshit! I linked it several times and I posted it on your wall, motherfucker!
You're fucking blatant. You linked it to me like 2 days ago. But I did download that fucking cover of Sail by Devil Driver.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
I'm not sure if I like it or not, to be honest.
I don't like the vocals in it. The music's good.
Yeah. Yeah.
The vocals. I don't like the vocals in the actual song, though.
Really?
Yeah.
I like it.
Sail!
See, I like it. I think it fits. I don't know. It sounds okay to me, I guess.
Yeah, you would.
Yeah.
But is that their new fucking album?
I think it is, honestly.
Is that going to be on Punk Goes Crunk?
Dude, it should. I would put it on
or
there.
Or Punk Goes Pop, I guess. Is what
I would say about like 50% of the covers I like. Actually, no, it's probably less than that,
yeah,
actually.
But the ones I like, I really, really like.
Yeah, yeah.
It sticks out more.
Yeah, there's a couple that are really good, and there's a couple that are really bad.
Yeah. Like, didn't even know what they were doing. Mayday Parade like, always has good covers.
Yeah, Mayday Parade is, like, the best at doing fucking, like, pop rap covers or whatever you want to call them.
Yeah, because I think they have, like, kind of a hip-hop musicality anyway.
I don't think they do.
I disagree.
I disagree.
End of topic.
Well, I'm glad we wrote down a list of topics.
Scene transition!
Bits.
Nope, we're just bullshitting. We're fumbling through this first podcast, see how it turns out, and then we're gonna actually have a.
I guess mostly, we're kind of deciding like how this will turn out sound wise, because.
Yeah, because really, what I think is gonna happen.
We honestly probably need mics.
Is yeah, we're gonna have to get actual recording equipment.
Yeah,
but
that'd be a lot easier. Dude, I was actually thinking yesterday. Check this out. Once a week, we can stream like we're news on Twitch TV.
You know, for like 35, I'm gonna say 75% of that sentence. I thought you were going, we can stream that we're nude.
Nude, we could.
And I was like, yes.
There are some porn stars or former porn stars that stream on there, and they frequently show their titties. And I'm pretty sure dick pics are popular now, so we could probably just show.
Who wants
our
to
ways.
See a dick? It looks like a vagina threw up. Dicks are ugly as fuck. Mine looks like a sad face. Mine looks like Droopy the dog. Going down, sir.
I don't know. I just pole vault all the time. I just wake up and like pole vault down my bed usually.
Wake up with morning wood and fly out your window because your fucking dick hits the ground. You're like, oh no!
That's actually really plausible for me since my window like faces right the direction of my bed where I get up.
That's fucking badass.
But have you ever seen me out there, like, in my yard, like, incapacitated with a boner? That's probably what happened.
Hey, like, what is this? Why you hold a broomstick? Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. The one girl's face.
Yep. That her oh, fuck.
That face is priceless. I wish I could make it.
You know, it's fucked up. It reminds me of Tiffany Dennis a little bit.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm trying to picture it.
I'm just going to go ahead and say you won't agree with me, but...
But I just can't see it yet. I don't know. I can't see it. I don't know.
Dude, for real? This is going on right now? Fucking pony?
Yeah.
G.U.I.!
I love that. I want someone to get on there for me.
Riding
the same.
My pony!
Emma Watson making the troll face is pretty sweet.
Yeah, that's funny.
That's like
she
really,
does it really
that's actually
good.
Really accurate, unintentionally accurate.
I'm just not a huge Emma Watson fan.
Dude, she's got a really crazy banging ass. I didn't realize that till like yesterday.
Well, she's British, so she's probably got curves. What's up with British chicks and having huge titties?
Examples?
Lucy Pender.
I don't know who that is.
Elizabeth Berkley. The chick from the Austin Powers movie.
Oh, I don't remember her boobs being big.
Yeah, they're fucking out of control.
Okay,
I guess Kate Beckinsale's aren't too big, but
no, they are, dude.
So she's hot though.
They are. She's got big boobies.
She's pretty fucking.
See, I think she was only hot when she was doing the vampire shit. Not so much now without it.
Riding my pony. Sorry, Genuine moment.
I know Genuine's awesome.
His other song I like is that In Those Jeans song.
In those jeans. I don't know the rest of the words.
In those jeans.
That's like kind of like the voice we do for like every song.
I know. That's like my all-purpose go-to R&B impersonation.
Like, I don't.
Yeah, you know Barry White. My darling.
I was, for some reason yesterday, or not yesterday, but like a couple days ago, like I was sitting there, I was playing Diablo 3. And I before I got on there, I turned on some music, and for some reason, I looked up slow jams, and I had a slow jams playlist going while playing Diablo 3.
What is that any good, first of all?
What, Diablo 3?
Yeah.
I think it's okay.
Okay.
It eventually gets monotonous, because the fact that you're like, you get level 60, and then you try to get Paragon levels, which is just shit above that, mm-hmm. which, I don't know. It's a lot of grinding. I have a wizard and a barbarian and a demon hunter.
A wizard sleeve.
Oh god. My wife's vagina hang like sleeve of wizard's robe.
You cast a spell on me, man. But what about the other games that you purchased? I mean, like,